Introducing the instructors this week. We'll have courses by four teachers this week. The first one, Jean Bricmont, hasn't arrived yet, so his plane was delayed and then he missed his connecting flight. He will arrive during the day today. As a consequence of that, we had to change the order of the talks a bit and switch between Monday and Tuesday, so Jean will not give any talks today. He will give his talk, his first talk, tomorrow morning. And I will, actually for you it doesn't make a big difference because the times of the lectures remain the same. It's just the ordering of the lectures is different. I will update the timetable and put it online. But speaking of the timetable, there's one more thing that I should say, one more change in the timetable, and that is the group dinners. We meet at 7:30, not at 8 o'clock. On the timetable, I wrote 8 o'clock, but we should do it a little bit earlier. We meet at 7:30 every evening for the group dinner. So we meet here, and then from here, Ivan and his helpers will drive us to where we need to go.
Maybe you should remind people to write their name and their choice of a meal on the list if they cannot done it yet.
Yes, exactly. As Franjo said, don't forget to sign up for dinners. So Ivan has the list. Everybody here knows Ivan, our host here. This list passed for everybody to put their names last night. And I will pass it around again today. Good. Let me say a few things about Jean. He is from Louvain in Belgium. He has done work in mathematical physics and theoretical physics. So much of his work is mathematically oriented. He has worked particularly in statistical mechanics and statistical quantum mechanics. So some of his work is on the renormalization group and derivation of Fourier's law, that means heat transfer. He has also written several books, two of them about the foundations of quantum mechanics. One is called Making Sense of Quantum Mechanics, another one, Quantum Sins and Nonsense, that is for, I have looked at this book I can recommend this one. I have looked at. I was told it's more for the broader public, more like a popular science book. He's also known for his book Fashionable Nonsense, written together with Alan Sokol, in which he criticized postmodern philosophers for misuse of science. Lev Weinman, Lev, would you get up? So he is the professor of theoretical physics at Tel Aviv University in Israel. He has done extensive work in foundations of quantum mechanics, particularly on the many worlds interpretation, and he is known particularly for work on quantum teleportation, weak values. The Elitzur-Weidman bomb tester carries his name, and he has also worked on numerous paradoxes in quantum. Matthias Lienert. Matthias is in the back.
Hello.
He's a postdoctoral researcher in the math department at Johann Hans University in Tübingen, which is where I am as well. He got his PhD from Ludwig Maximilians University in Munich, and he worked for a time at Rutgers University in the United States. His work is in mathematical physics, particularly on covariant formulations of relativistic quantum mechanics, in particular with multi-time wave functions. And let me introduce myself. So at the time I had a different haircut. Now it's summer. So please call me Roddy. And by the way, I think we should just do it the American way. You know, I spent a lot of years in the United States, and we should just call each other by first name. And this is not a sign of lack of respect or anything. It's just an easy way of talking to each other. I'm teaching at Eberhard Karls University in Tübingen, and 9 years at Rutgers. And my field is mathematical physics, particularly foundations of quantum mechanics and relativity, questions that have to do with quantum mechanics and relativity and quantum statistical mechanics. A few more remarks about the how I think we should do it here. At the end of each lecture, so for each lecture I have planned an 18-minute slot. At the end of each lecture, we should have a question and answer period, and students should get priority for asking questions. So the more senior people, the professors in the audience, they will get a chance to ask questions or make comments after the students. But please feel free to ask questions anytime, also in the middle of lectures. Also feel free to approach the instructors with questions during breaks and meals anytime. That's what the school is for. We will have exercise sessions on Tuesday and Thursday in the early afternoon. These are meant for doing problem solving. So we have prepared a set of problems, which are some are kind of math problems, some are more about the physical or philosophical aspects. They will review material that that we talked about in the lectures, and they are meant to deepen the understanding of what was said in the lectures. During these exercise sessions, the instructors will be here and will available for questions. And as Franny said, I should remind you, please sign up for group dinners if you want to join. Okay, now, there's one more thing I should mention. So we want to film all the lectures and put them online afterwards. So